at the Bridgestone booth, PGA Show 2019 with Elliot. Elliot, here to talk about the brand new E12. Just give me the basic overview and then we'll dive in deep.
Well, E12, it's twice as good as E6, obviously. Kidding aside, guys, the E12 name comes from the 12 years of ball fitting data that we use to design this product. So in our database, over 2.5 million swings, Bridgestone, as well as competitive product. And so what the R&D team does is they go in there and they look, what are the holes in the marketplace? What are the areas of opportunity to innovate, okay? And so ultimately what we saw kind of at the mid-segment here, at the distance performance category, we saw there's been this trend of soft core golf balls. You and I have both seen it, that the guys on THP see it all the time. And soft is great, it delivers a feel preference, but what we've noticed is that the balls have gotten soft to the point of degradation from a performance standpoint. And so what I mean by that is, as the core gets so soft, we start to lose ball velocity. So we're seeing a lot of golf balls out there across all manufacturers, in fairness, that are they're delivering feel, they're delivering optimum trajectory, but the ball velocity isn't quite where it was, say, 3 or 4 years ago. So with that thought in mind, the R&D engineers went out and they said, all right, how can we maintain this feel but get better velocity performance? And so ultimately that comes in the form of our new active acceleration mantle layer. So the mantle between the cover and the core, it's a denser chemical compound, and so what it does is it allows increased thrust, increased initial ball velocity. So now we essentially have our speed and our power coming from two regions of the golf ball, both the core and the mantle. So kind of two engines in the ball, if you will. So since we have added velocity from the mantle, we are able to maintain that soft feel on the core. So to me, it's kind of a transcending technology, because a lot of manufacturers, Bridgestone competitive as well, a lot of times the new innovation comes at the tour ball level and then is recycled or trickled down into the distance category and the value category in subsequent years. So the fact that we're energizing the mid segment, the distance segment, with our new flagship technology, the active acceleration mantle, is rather intriguing and quite contrarian to how golf balls are typically made. And I think the performance is through the roof. We've seen it with the media, with the consumer, and we're very excited for everyone to hit it.
So you talked about the mantle layer and the cover. How much of this has been materials? How much is just working about thickness? How much of this has been understanding, hey, this is the data we've got and pointing you in the right direction? There's a lot of great stuff there. So how did you say, hey, this is the area we really want to attack and then build off of that in the design process?
Yeah, so something to understand about Bridgestone Golf is we are one of 150 plus Bridgestone units globally. So combined, we have over 900 polymer engineers, rubber engineers worldwide. So we're able to lean on people in maybe say the race car division or the roofing division and kind of borrow technologies. And so there's going to be two keywords to think of here. One is surfactant and one is catalyst. And so as we think about the polymers happening, we added a surfactant, which essentially makes a material more liquid, makes it spread out faster. And then we add a catalyst, which is it's a reactive agent. It makes a reaction happen quicker. So if we think about that, we have a material that is spreading quickly and reacting and bonding quickly. And so it creates a less porous, a more dense compound, and that more dense compound is more efficient, which is where our speed's coming from.
So as somebody who's tested lots of golf balls in the past, one of the things I've found about Bridgestone in my experience is it's one of, if not the most consistent golf ball out there from a manufacturing standpoint, from ball to ball, box to box consistency. How is that factored in and knowing that when guys do get fit, they're getting the right product?
Well, you know, it's great to work at a company like Bridgestone because our product does what we say it's going to do. You know, when you come to our facility and you see the manufacturing, there's over 120 mechanical checkpoints and hand checkpoints for every golf ball that goes through the line. So we're not spot checking a dozen out of 3,000 like some of the companies. We're actually going through the process with every particular golf ball. From a manufacturing and patent standpoint, we have over 800 patents that relate to the construction and the performance of the golf ball, but also to the manufacturing. Ultimately, the consistency that you reference is from the manufacturing side, which is what we do very well.
So not that it matters in performance necessarily, but obviously there's some pretty colors behind us as well. Tell us about the thought process went into that. What went into selecting just the perfect red, just the perfect shade of white? And yes, there are shades of white.
That's a good question. So the global Bridgestone mantra is serving society with superior quality. So when we set out a couple of years ago to enter the matte segment, we wanted to come with a solution that wasn't just a visual solution, but also had a performance benefit to it. And so when we came out with the active acceleration mantle on E12, we said, all right, this is a great way to have performance plus visual instead of just being that solely the optical story that exists in the market right now. In terms of colors, we do pride ourselves on the durability of the color, the ability of the red golf ball to maintain its red and not be kind of dulled by UV lights or fade over time. So within the E12 portfolio, for the E12 softs, we have a matte red version, a matte green, and a matte yellow.
So they told me and they just told you it's twice as good as the E6. Check it out.